Okay, today I'm going to talk about IDE interfacing with ROS. So let's check it out. I'm going to follow this tutorial. There is Notepad, and there are many softwares for that. Like for example, Eclipse, CodeBlocks, Invictus. Eclipse is pretty famous one, so I'm going to talk about Eclipse. So let's download it from here. I'm already using Robotic Linux. By the way, I'm using Linux 16.06 and ROS Kinetic. So let's just take this one and then first course. So just save it, and it is already saved in my download folder here. Just unzip it, and I have already unzipped it here. After that, run this installer. Okay, in this there are many different installers for different purposes, particularly for our application we are going to use this one, Eclipse IDE for C and C++ development. So we are going to install this one. So just install it as it is, and I have already installed it. Let's close it. Okay. So after the installation, first you need to go to the terminal. You have to do some settings. Let's check it out. First we need to go to our testing workspace, and we have to tell our Linux. That include ROS all commands in this memory and using this number. Now we are gonna use this command. Please note that it is 2.2 function and force. Let's go here and compute it. So it will compile everything, and it will enable the collapse command. I have many packages in my workspace, so that's why it's taking time. After running that command, we have to run this command. So please note that awk space minus f go. So you can place it in here by Control Shift V. So normally we use Control plus V, then it is placed, but for Linux in particular terminal, we have to place Control Shift and V. So there you go, and then we have to go to the build folder, which is in my Captain workspace here. So I go in this folder, and then I have to run this command. Now to run Eclipse, we have to go where it is installed. It is installed here in my home folder, Eclipse, CTVNode, Eclipse, and just run this. So you will see this app. It will ask you for the workspace, just say OK. We're gonna see some project, for example, how to make a project like this. No. Anyhow, you're gonna see the project. You need to make it with any name, like robot control. I have done this. And then we have to go here and then import here and give it the path, which is existing workspace, next, and then browse cat can workspace, which is here, and this is my cat can workspace, this one. I use this one for temporary purposes, I'm not going to use this. So this is my cat can workspace where we have use these commands, and I'm going to give this folder right there. So it's here, so let's just finish it. Now we are here, and there are many folders because I have many many packages. So just forget about all these things, just focus on source directory, and I'm gonna, for the source directory, I'm gonna focus on chapter number 2 tutorials, and in this the source. Before I discuss any other thing, let me tell you that this particular folder is obtained from this book. Let me show you the book. Yeah. This is the book. Learning ROS for Robotics Programming 2nd edition, and the code I'm using is taken from this chapter. This, if you go online and you download its programs, which is pretty easy, if you don't, just comment on my video. I shall link that, I shall give you the link. So just download the programs, which is here, and copy chapter 2 tutorials and just place it. So here I have chapter 2 tutorials, and this is the file I'm gonna see how it works. Example 1, and let's go to e.c. Okay, now you see in my computer you will not see any problem, but in your case there will be different kind of problems. First of all, let me show you how to resolve those problems. So first you need to go to the properties, and then properties C and C++ general, and then you need to go to the preprocessor include task here under providers. There will be file name, which will be like cdtgcc built-in compiler settings, and this will be unchecked, and there will be like shared with it. So like this, you will see like this, you have to check it and apply, and then okay. And after doing that, you have to right click and then go to the index and then rebuild your project. So you will see it will take some time, and because I have many projects in my workspace, so it is taking time. Generally the good practice is to initiate a different workspace, develop your package in there, and then and then just move it to your main workspace. Otherwise, whenever you run it, it will take some time. So it is taking time because I have many projects in there. Okay, now it is done. Now we have to do some more things. Properties, and then C++ make product. And then we have to go to the C++. Environment, and then please check that these values are assigned. One of them is ROS underscore root, and then ROS underscore package underscore cat, and then python cat, and these should be checked. These values can only be checked and can also be checked by the terminal. So you can write call and ROS underscore true. If it gives you this, it means it's there. And then underscore key is there. Okay. So it's already there. And so on. I'm particularly executing, I'm particularly following this portion. So that you know this portion. So you can also obtain the correct values. So just copy it and then paste it. It will give you the correct values. Okay, now what I have to do is to, my project is almost ready. But before going in this, I have to do some configuration. It is called run configuration. Just click in this icon, on the below, and then go to the run configuration. In run configuration, there are C and C++ applications, which is this one. C and C++ applications, and just double click on it and then it will come up with this. Here you have to go you should make sure that this project and that project is same. Project is for debug and scoping. And then you have to go to the which is the environment, and in here you have to add these two things. I'm explaining this portion right now. So we are doing run configuration, C++ interpret, now ROS underscore lock. We have to do this. So let's just do this. ROS underscore lock. And enter the value, we need to go and check it out from here. Call dollar sign ROS underscore. So we have to copy this. Remember to copy from Linux, you have to use Control plus C plus Shift plus C. Normally we are using Control plus C, but for terminal, in terminal we use Control plus Shift plus C. So copy and use Control plus C. And then we also have to add ROS underscore master underscore UI. And again, particularly challenge this one. And to get its value, you need to write echo underscore boss underscore master underscore UI. And here is the value. Just copy it. Sorry, I need to copy the shift. Control plus shift plus E, C. And then I have to make it. Apply and then close. So after that I have to do debugging for the debug configuration. I need to go with this icon to the configuration and then C and C++ remote applications. We have to give here the binary value, which is standard given from here. Okay, for to give the binary value, we need to go to the home, our workspace, and then our workspace we have to go in the dev folder, LID, and then check the tutorials, and then the file we're gonna debug. So this is the file we're gonna use it. So give the right binary value. So that's what we have. Okay. And debug. So now it's going to be debug. Now one very important part is this will come, this kind of watch is configured to open debug perspective when it suspends. So this debug perspective is designed to support application debugging. It incorporates views for displaying debug stacks, variables, breakpoints, management. Do you want to open this perspective now? So answer is yes, because we want to see all these things. So let's see. So all these things are open. Now, you know, we are in the, our cursor is here, and we are going to debug this code. Remember that we cannot debug this code without running ROS code. So let's go and run the ROS code. I'm going home there, so let's run ROS code. Oh, ROS code is running. So to debug this code, we have three options. This one. So let's start from here. So one. And if you press one more time, it will go inside. I think I showed you. So it has opened. It is clear now. And now it has opened the main header file in which this definition is here. So if you want to go back from here to here, you have to use this one. So now it is back. Now if you want to go again to see what is in there, it will open a middle header. It will give you, will show you the header file it is calling, so it will come here and we're gonna go back, just use this one. So I don't want to go to the header file again and again, I want to stick here. Okay, let's just see what is going on. So it is in the loop, and it is publishing this. I'm example one node. So when you want to stop, just if you want to run it continuously, yeah, it is not. If you want to stop, pause it, or you want to stop. Okay, can't find the source. Okay, I don't know about it. Let's say that we want to see it. Debug configuration. Everything is fine. Oh, we need to add the right. Okay. Now everything is fine. Okay, let's debug it. So there we go. Here. I don't know everything about it, so that's what I'm doing right now. I think it will be really helpful to you. So wanna stop? Just stop.